Hello there, my music lovers. I'm Joshua de Falheaven, and today we're having a look at the BQEAZ or BQEAZ Spring 2. It uses the dynamic driver combined with a 9-layer piezoelectric driver plus a balanced armature. So they basically put everything in there. Everything they have, just throw them in. I want to see how it sounds. This is how the director of the sound and the company was probably like when designing the BQEAZ Spring 2. Since they decided to go with such a bold move, I'm going to give them the credit due for their decision. They actually made a very interesting EM. This comes in multiple versions of cables, of course, because they come with a single and a 3.5mm cable, with a balanced 2.5mm cable, and even with a balanced 4.4mm cable. They have every single version of cable available for you. The price is about $170, price at which it has a lot of competition. And it manages to really live to the task of beating that competition, even though it has 3 tech of drivers inside. I'm passionate about the BQEAZ Spring 2. It is a very interesting EM and I'm a big fan of it. The unboxing is not quite that underwhelming for the price point. They are priced at $170. Usually the 2 EMs would have been here, but I've placed them inside that carrying case. And I'm going to give a big, huge shout out to the guys at Didi Hi-Fi, because Didi Hi-Fi creates adapters. And some of those adapters can be really handy. For example, they have an adapter that converts a 2.5mm balanced cable to a 3.5mm single-ended cable. This means that I was able to test the BQEAZ Spring 2 with pretty much everything because I have the 2.5mm balanced version. They have a metallic plate on which you can find the tips, and they even give you explanation about what each of the tips do. As you can see, they thought quite a bit about what tips to include, and they actually included an atmosphere and the reference tip. Basically, I would guess that the atmosphere has a wider soundstage, although upon testing I couldn't really tell them apart so well. The comfort was better with the normal tip, and I kept using that one for the time being. This is the EM and the cable. As you can see, they have a beautiful cable. I am a big fan of this cable, and I like EMs that come with high quality cables from the factory. There are very expensive flagship EMs out there that do not come with this quality of a cable. And if a Chinese company could do it for a very affordable EM, I'm pretty sure everyone can do it if they want to. The carrying case is of a very good quality, and even compared to the Art Magic VG4 from BGVP, the BQEAZ Spring 2 actually has a better overall carrying case. It has that leathery kind of feeling to it, and it is of a better quality all in all. Inside the case you can find the cleaning tool. It is a very ugly cleaning tool. I don't really see this as being very useful. It has a little brush which is very solid, but also the hairs of the brush are very long, so I would not recommend it for cleaning. They do come with 2 tiny foam tips. So 2 tiny foam tips for the Spring 2, and they look kinda cute in this little box. And inside the case I have decided to leave the Didi Hi-Fi adapter. This is a very high quality adapter, and it has enabled me to do some tests on the BQEAZ Spring 2. The Spring 2 has a very, very nice cable. It is just fantastic. I love this cable. It is just amazing. The cable has the best quality of a cable I've seen lately, and I'm a big fan of this. They have a full metallic housing, and they have a lot of venting. I have not seen this much venting in an EM for a while. And since they have both dynamic drivers, piezoelectric drivers, they have balanced armatures, they did well to include this much venting. As you can see, there are about 3 holes on the inner part of the EM that take care of the venting. And there is that Spring 2 tiny logo to give some personality to the BQEAZ Spring 2 EMs. They don't really lack personality, but they don't have the strongest personality either, so they are at a medium there. They have this tangle-free, soft, high-quality cable. I cannot tell you how much I'm enjoying having this cable. Well, it seems it is enjoying me as well, and the comfort and ergonomics are pretty much excellent. I'm having a very good time. The cable is detachable too, just so you know. And when fitting them, I'm getting excellent comfort on both ears. I'm having one of the best times while wearing the BQEAZ Spring 2. There are about 15 to 20 decibels of passive noise isolation, and I can somewhat hear my air conditioning running in the background. That is something that is passing through the passive noise isolation, so you'll be able to hear something. things. For example, if you go on the street, you'll hear cars, you'll hear people shouting at you. That is something to take into account. They don't isolate quite that well. There are much better isolating EMs out there, and most of those that isolate better are best on only balanced armature drivers. So if you do have a dynamic driver, you are going to need some venting to avoid driver flex, and that is going to affect the passive noise isolation. Speaking of driver flex, there is none with the Spring 2, and I'm excited about this because having no driver flex means you are going to get an excellent comfort with them. They will be comfortable to wear for hours in a row. They will be just nice. Everything will be just nice. On the other hand, I should note that they are at the very limit of being drivable out of a smartphone. They really eat a bit more power. They have a pretty low sensitivity of 103 decibels, and that is not the best sensitivity compared with the 32 ohm impedance. This leads to an EM that is somewhat hard to drive, and my smartphone, the Xiaomi Redmi Note 9S, is barely keeping in line with the BQAZ Spring 2. So if you need something that is very easy to drive, there are other options out there. Those will be best if you already have a source like the Hidesis EPI 80 Pro or Shanling M2X or FIO M11 or iBASO DX160. You just need a DAC for them. I do not recommend those out of a smartphone. Even a portable DAC would do just well, like the FIO BTR5 or Lotopo S1. There are a lot of options. Just don't expect them to sound so good out of a smartphone. In terms of sonics, they could be described as being very lively. They are somewhat V-shaped, so both the bass and the side bass are enhanced above the mid-range, which is below the treble, which is also uplifted. It is a V-shape. The V-shape means that the edges are uplifted and the mid is recessed. This results in a somewhat enjoyable sound, especially on the street, on the go, where you generally hear less treble and less bass because you are already moving. So they can be enjoyed on the go quite well, and that is a good thing for an EM. The cable not having hard guides also helps with that. There are soft guides on the cable, and it means that the entire EM is just enjoyable on the go, and that is a very fun thing. Another interesting thing I've noticed when using the BQAZ Spring 2 was that they have a very good revealing ability without being harsh and without having any amount of grain. Where the BGVP Art Magic VG4 was pretty grainy, and I mentioned that quite a lot, the BQAZ Spring 2 is not grain. It has no grain at all, just like no sand. They are just so smooth. The texture is smooth, so they are enjoyable. They are not fatiguing. They have a somewhat splashy character, which means that they are pretty easy to enjoy with a lot of music, especially rock and metal. They have excellent detail. They have a somewhat wide soundstage, so the soundstage is pretty wide, but it is not very deep. The bass has natural speed. The entire sound has a pretty natural speed, despite there being so much tech inside. No part of the sound is incoherent with the other parts. So the bass has natural speed, the mid-range has natural speed, the treble has natural speed. If you asked me, I would tell you quite honestly that I do think that the entire putting all of this tech in one EM is pretty much a marketing strategy. I don't think that it really means much towards the final sound. Of course, those designs that rely on just one balanced armature tend to have a somewhat dry sound in general. Most of them has the same sound, and they have a very limited headroom, so you cannot really EQ EMs that are BA only or which have one BA. Well, with the BQAZ Spring 2, you can EQ them quite a lot, but I felt no need to EQ them, and I've been enjoying them on the default setting. They don't have any switches, they don't have any replaceable filters, but they sound amazing. They sound amazing like this, as they are. You don't need more than this to enjoy them. Of course, that is if you enjoy a V-shaped sound. As I've been saying, they have a pretty V-shaped sound. The sound is somewhat splashy. It is also a bit sibilant, but it has no harshness, no grain. It is very easy to listen to with female voices, with male voices, with very energetic music. There is nothing that they cannot do well, so it is a pretty good all-rounder. They pretty much work with everything. If there was a music style that they don't work best with, that would be probably classical, because classical is a bit more picky with the mid-range presentation, and when it comes to that mid-range, it is only okay. For $170, it is excellent, but when I sit down and I want to enjoy some classical music, I tend to invest a bit more in the experience. I have tried pairing the BQAZ Spring 2 with the best DAP I have right now, and that is the Ibeiso DX220 Max, the 1 kilogram of a DAP. And let me tell you, this is able to drive them, to make them play and to make them sing. But at the same time, they don't scale quite up to this level. So an Ibeiso DX160 is more than enough for the BQAZ Spring 2. If you really want to squeeze a bit more performance out of them, I would recommend not getting a better DAP and not getting a better cable. I would recommend accepting them as they are, because there isn't that much more to squeeze after you have a mid-range DAP and you have them in their default state. If you really, really want to experiment and to get the most you can out of them, do some tip rolling. So try more tips, even other tips than the one included in the package. You can try SpinFit. I am a big fan of SpinFits, and mine came with a 2.5 millimeter balanced cable. And I guess that the reason the company decided to do this is that this way they will sound the best with the source you have, because most sources are implemented to sound best or to sound better out of a balanced source. That is a big point, because if you get them with a balanced cable, you are always going to connect them to the best your source can do. If you connect them to the single-ended port, you may get the lesser sonic output of your source. I thank you for watching. I hope this video has been enjoyable to watch. Don't forget to ask some questions in the comment if you want me to help you with anything. I hope you'll consider subscribing to Audiophile Heaven to see more content from me. Also, press like on this video. It really helps me and keeps my motivation going up, up, up. I thank you for watching, and we'll see each other really soon. Bye bye.